Hello. This is a demo of Augur, which is a tool to convert data into Org mode. And in particular, I'm going to be demonstrating our own research module. And as input data, I'm going to be using public COVID-19 database, which you can also access. And you can browse it and export data for yourself and play with it. And so here we go. This is the output of the tool, and it represents the same data that's contained in our own research database. So what's up with org mode, you probably ask. The best bit about having your data as a regular org mode file is that you benefit from all the existing infrastructure tools for org mode. Obviously, the most famous one is Emacs, and Emacs and org mode got lots of features, some of which I'm not even aware of. And I'll demonstrate the ones I find myself using the most often. So obviously, as you can see, you get syntax highlight and markup. You get links, you get colors, you get bold text, whatnot. And Rome markup maps in a pretty straightforward way to org mode, which is not very surprising, perhaps. Next thing I want to show is navigation. And the great bit about having your data as org mode is that you get to use the key bindings you already know. So in Emacs, if you're using Emacs key bindings, you can just carry on and use them. I'm personally using evil mode, which brings me Vim key bindings in my Emacs. So, you know, you get J, K, you can jump through words, whatever. So the great bit about that is you don't have to learn anything new. You just use the same key bindings you already know, which is awesome. You don't have to get used to some new key bindings. And next thing I wanted to show is folding. Obviously, this is a huge document. We can jump to the end, it's like 1,200 lines. So you want some way to oversee it. And in org mode, you can do it with Shift-Tab press. So it folds everything, and you overview all your top-level notes. Cool. So next thing I want to show is you may notice these crosses, little crosses. These are permalinks. So if I press it, I jump straight into Rome Research interface to that node. So it's loading. Here you go. So you can just access the same node in Rome web interface. As you can see, it contains the same data. Cool. Next thing. We can navigate through the top-level headings where it's familiar org mode key bindings. And it goes without saying that you can expand and collapse individual headings as well. So you might notice that you get two different link types. Ones that are underlined and orange. That's orange, right? I think so. These are external links, and as in, they would bring you into a web browser, as I just demonstrated. And the blue links are internal links. In Rome Research, they would jump throughout your nodes. So again, this concept also maps into org mode. Say you wanna jump into individual best practice node. Obviously, we can just do a mouse click and jump, but if you a stubborn keyboard user like myself, you probably hate moving away your hands from your keyboard. And in your web browser, you might have an extension like Vimperator or Surfing Keys, which gives you tooltips when you press a key binding, so you can jump onto links without having to just by typing on your keyboard. We have the same functionality available in Emacs, so you can press a key binding and you get tooltips for your links. So if we want to jump onto individual best practice, we have to type LDFA. And obviously when you know, in a flow, you're doing it very fast, but I'll just do it slowly to demonstrate. LDF, and now we type A, and here you go, we jumped onto individual best practice node. Cool. Next feature I want to demonstrate, it's called Swoop, which is the name of Emacs module. And it's easier to show what it does and to explain what is it. It's used for search. So you press a key binding, you open, a prompt opens. Say you want to find stuff about N95 masks. So you type N95, and here you go. In the bottom, you get your search results. You can overlook them. And as you go through them, in the top, you get this result in the context, which I find super useful. And the best thing is it searches as you type. So if you want to search N95 masks, it instantly narrows down search results, which is very convenient. Next thing I want to show, it's specific to my Emacs setup. It's a global key, it's a key binding for global search. So I can invoke it from anywhere, even if I don't have Emacs open. So I press a key binding, I get a prompt again, so I can start typing and searching. Say I wanna find something about respirators. And here you go. As you can see, I've got several results. First one, it's our ROM database. Second is my hypothesis ROM, hypothesis remote expert. It's a hypothesis annotation service. The third one is my private org mode files, which is so, and I get to search over everything. So it's like Google across all of your personal data. And again, it's also instantaneous, and it changes results as you type. So if you want to, if you made a typo and you actually wanted to find respiration, you do it and you instantly get results, which is very cool. This instant search is something you don't get with most of web applications. Just to clarify, I don't mean Rome here, because Rome Research does support incremental search, but most of web services don't. And it's a pretty pathetic, search is pretty pathetic to use in most web services. And one thing I've got to warn you, this instant search workflow is very addictive. And once you experience it, you won't be able to go back, and you're going to be grumpy and frustrated, like myself, when you're trying to search in web apps. That's all features I wanted to show for today. And as a closing note, I guess most of what I demonstrated, it's not specific to Rome Research. It's just power of Emacs, org mode, some extra packages, and ability to tweak your Emacs to your own liking. And you can achieve similar workflow with any other data source. And it's fairly easy to adapt with Augur. Yeah, so thanks for watching.